Hello everybody, my name is Leo, and if you follow my channel, you know that I have already done a demo review of the Strymon Iridium and another video in which I have integrated the Iridium in a complete pedalboard. I am pretty happy with the Iridium and I think that it sounds great. So, in the today video, I would like to verify with you how close it can get to a Marshall Plexi, more specifically to my Marshall SV20. Answering also the question, can we replace our Plexi with the Iridium? Now, when I was thinking about this video, I was wondering how could I make the comparison fair and honest? You know, the Plexi has so much more controls and knobs compared to the Iridium. And furthermore, if I had also to mic the amp, many other factors could have influenced the sound, like for instance the positions of the mix, the preamp, and so on and so forth. So, in order to make this comparison realistic, I decided, first of all, to remove the cabinet, microphone, and preamp from the, I would say, equation. Therefore, the Marshall is going through a surreactive load and then to an API 512 preamp, and then is recorded in the computer. On the other hand, I have also removed the cabinet IRs from the Iridium, sending it still through an API 512 preamplifier and then in the computer. So they are exactly in the same recording environment, I would say. Then, in my digital audio workstation, I've loaded the same IR in the Torpedo Wall of Sound plugin for both the Marshall and the Iridium, that is an IR of a Celestion Greenback. So no cabinet, microphone placement and so on involved in the comparison. As regard the knobs, well, here I had many doubts. For instance, you know that the Plexi has two channels that can be jumpered together. What about the Iridium? Is it modeling the two channels jumpered or not? We don't know. So I decided to go in this way. I think that one of the most famous settings of the Plexi is the one with the two channels jumpered and the gain level maxed out. Also because the Plexi is really touch responsive and so you can modulate distortion just modifying your touch. So, the two channels of the Plexi are gonna be jumpered and we will start the comparison with the gain levels of the Plexi maxed out. Maxing out, on the other hand, also the Iridium drive. Actually, in the Strymon website, it is stated, setting the drive control at around 2 o'clock gets you the maximum gain the original Plexi design allowed. Beyond that, our model has some additional gain on top, giving you access to custom hot-rodded Plexi high-gain tones. So well, we can also verify if this is true. As regards the bass, mid and low EQ knobs, I would put all three in the middle for both the Marshall and the Iridium. My last doubt was the presence knob, as we know that it has a pretty high impact on the sound of the Plexi, also contributing to the distortion level of this amp. But you know, as the Iridium does not actually have such knob, I would keep the Marshall at none. One more thing to notice is that I will switch between the Marshall and the Iridium using the Electro Harmonix parallel mixer. But now, without further ado, let's hear the differences. Let's start our test. We have everything to noon in the Marshall but the loudness volumes, both maxed out. And I have everything to noon in the Iridium but the drive that is on its maximum level. The amp is the punch, that is the Marshall. Cab doesn't matter because the cab is bypassed. So that we have the cabinet simulation only coming from the Torpedo Wall of Sound. Let's start our test with the Iridium. I'm pretty curious. Marshall. Very different. To me, the Marshall has much more bass frequencies than the one of the iridium. So let's try to max out the bass frequency in the iridium. Are still different. So let's try to be more drastic in the Marshall, removing all the bass frequencies. Marshall with the bass frequencies removed. Now they are very close, even in terms of equalization. Let's now use the guitar playing some riffs. I want to check out the level of gain, if they are equal, or if the iridium has more gain, as stated in the Strymon website. Marshall. Iridium. Yes, actually the iridium is a little bit more gaining. And you can even feel that more gain when you play. The notes are a little bit more sustained in the iridium than in the Marshall. Let's see how they cleans up. Try to remove a little bit of gain from the iridium. Marshall. So now the iridium seems like to lack a little bit of high. Maybe removing the drive, the height are a little bit less. So let's try to add some more height to the iridium. Once more, digging a little bit more. I think that they sound really very, very similar with these settings. But we have to say that we have removed all the bass frequencies from the Marshall, and we have the bass frequencies all the way up in the Iridium. So I don't know why, but the Iridium has much less bass frequencies than the Marshall. One thing to notice is that when you use the Iridium in a mix or in a band or in a live contest, I don't think you are gonna miss these bass frequencies, because in these bass frequencies you are going to compete with the bass guitar or with the kick of the drum. In fact, actually, when I'm mixing a song, I am typically removing some bass frequencies from the guitars just to leave more space to the bass guitar or to the kick drums. So in an actual song, I don't think you are gonna miss these bass frequencies. So we have reached the end of this video, and let me try to answer to the initial question. Am I going to sell my Plexi, replacing it with the Iridium? Well, actually, no, I don't. In fact, whatever you think about the sound, even though you think that the Iridium sounds exactly as the Marshall, I still think that the Marshall has a lot more to offer. I mean, more nuances that you can obtain, for instance, with the presence knob, or deciding not to jump the channels, and so on and so forth. So, I'm not going to sell my Plexi, but for sure the level of realism that the Iridium has reached is really impressive. And for jigging, I think that it is so much more convenient than bringing with me a real amp. Well, but let me know your opinions. Are you going to sell your amp by an Iridium? Do you think that the Iridium sound exactly the same as your amp? I'm really curious to hear your thoughts and considerations. So, please, let's write them in the comment below. We have now reached the end of this video, I hope you enjoyed, and if you did it, please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell. It will be all a great time. See you in the next video. Bye bye!